Here we are again, Bugsy and Levy. We're going to talk about the principal parts of the Epsilon contract norms. Lisa's already written down the first principal part, which is given as Poyo, although only the real form they actually see is Poyo, spelling out that it's, if you just had Poyo and you just had Timo, you wouldn't be able to tell whether the underlying vowel is an Epsilon or an Alpha. And there's a third type, which also results in an Omega with a circle. So that's why we give the uncontracted form as the first principal part. But then, the same thing as happens with Timo happens with Poyo. That is, the stem becomes Poye with an eta in all the other forms. So it's Poyeso. Take your time. Poyeso. Et Poyeso. Okay, with your augment and your so suffix added on to the Poye stem. Te Poyeka. The perfective active forms. Te Poyemai. The perfective middle forms. And the aorist passive, e, poye, same. The augment, yeah, your poye suffix. So we've got this wonderful regularity to the way the system works. The book has another, open this up, teaches you one other song contract verb, I believe, and that's adikeo, okay? Principal parts of adikeo are going to be like that, it's going to be exactly the same in the forms of the present system that contract, that is the present, the imperfect, indicative and subjunctive, and the present infinitive, participle, and optative, subjunctive. Okay? That's it.